Celtics out of bounds. Fans are standing at Staples Center.
My name is Darrell Bailey.
Seat belts are fastened. Barron wants a screen.
I'm 48 years old.
Down the lane. The kick, the bumper for the tie.
I buy and sell cars. I became a Clipper fan because one day I got fired from a job. And a guy told me I never amount to anything in life.
You're fired.
You're fired.
Well, the good news is you're fired.
You know, you go home, you feel sorry for yourself, plops on the couch, turn the TV on. The announcers on the TV said the same thing about the Clippers, how horrible they was, how they never amount to anything in life. I said, this is going to be my team. We're going to ride and die together. That's how I became a Clipper fan. I became Clipper Darrell 16 seasons ago when I could actually afford season tickets. And I was so happy, you know, being able to watch my team every night at home. It was so beautiful. I started dancing in the aisles just having fun. So everybody called me the Dancing Man. One day, the radio stations that I used to talk on all the time, they were saying, man, we're tired of calling you the Dancing Man. We got to give you a name. And that's when Clipper Darrell was born, and been sticking with that ever since. When I first became on the Jumbotron, they played this song by 2 Unlimited, Are You Ready For This? And I started dancing in the aisle. The crowd went crazy. So they played me back in slow motion, and the crowd went crazy again. So after every game, they played the song, and that's how, and I danced in the aisle. You know, so when I heard that song, the camera turned toward me, and I just started dancing in the aisles, man. It was so much fun. It was a blast, man. And the crowd loved it. Being Clipper Darrell back in the day, man, was so much fun, man. You know, it was a blast. In 2006, Game 7, I went to the airport. My buddy Eddie said, Darrell, let's go down to the airport. He said, I'll meet you down there, right? So we shot that, so I got there first. So I'm standing outside, man, cheering the team on. We gonna do this, baby, let's go. You know, Elton Brand coming through, Corey McGetty, Sean Livingston, you know, Sam Cassell, you know what I'm saying? Then all of a sudden, I'm standing at the gate, cheering the team on. Donald Sterling walks up to me. He said, hi, Darrell. I'm Donald Sterling. I said, I know who you are. And it was crazy. And he said, man, how would you like to ride on the team playing with us? That's how I reacted. I was in shock that he wanted me to ride on a team play. So I called my wife at the time, and I said, baby, they just told me that I can ride on a team. She said, go. So, man, I parked my car, man, and jumped on the plane, man, with Donald T, man. It was the best experience of my life. For Donald Sterling to say black people not to come to the games was mind-blowing.
You put me on a plane. Why? You put me in a Ritz-Carlton. Why? Gave me tickets to the game. 2006. I'll never forget it. But why did you do all this if you don't like us?
The people that have negative things to say about me, all I tell them is I love you. Know me first. Don't ever judge a book by its cover. Don't go on what you read. I'm very approachable at games. Come to a Clipper game and find me and talk to me. You can ask me anything. I'm an open book. I don't have anything to hide. I'm a high energy guy. I don't like the arena to be quiet. Maybe they want to do what I do. You know what I'm saying? So if that's what they want to do, go get a red and blue suit. Put it on. Let's be twins and let's do it together. We only got one common goal, is to win a championship.
We love you, Clipper Darrell!
This is my home, baby. I love America, baby.